this design has been probably more well received than any other design I've ever made. So I had the inspiration of the idea because there's a guy named Michael Tank Fisher, otherwise known as T-Bar-K, who for years has been converting case copper locks into double action automatics. And a lot of people would see those and say, they're really cool. Wouldn't it be great to be able to convert the Swiss Army knife into an automatic? And the problem with that is there's actually no room inside for a spring. You know, you have the screwdrivers, the bottle opener, all these other parts. And then on the back side of the knife, you have a corkscrew and an awl. So you're really limited to space. There are the Swiss Army knives that have a larger blade that does lock open and lock closed. But again, you don't have room inside for a spring. So I drew up a design on paper. Everything I do, I draw on paper and make sure it'll work mechanically, make sure there's room inside for a spring. And the very first one I built had a button that had a G carved into it, and it was a latch release. And it worked really well, and a lot of people were really surprised when they saw it. And I show a video, and people are commenting saying, push the button, push the button. And then I push the button, and they're like, yes, they were so excited that it was a Swiss Army interpretation switchblade. So my name is Chuck Gedraitis. I am 44 years old. I live in Massachusetts. I've been interested in sharp objects for as long as I can remember. I've been making knives for over 25 years. So basically, I got real serious about it when I was about 16. I took my parents to a local knife show that still goes on today and showed them a whole room full of people interested in knives. And they said, okay, this is actually a thing. And I got some power tools for Christmas, and I've kind of been at it ever since. Everything I know is self-taught. Trial and error, slip joints, valley songs, automatics, you know, making a lot of mistakes, making a lot of pieces over because they didn't fit properly or they just didn't work. So all trial and error, all self-taught. So I designed one that was a scare release. I had never built a scare release before, but I searched the internet for pictures and videos and basically drew one up and figured out through trial and error how to make it work. And so the first scare release wasn't a Swiss Army switchblade. It was just a drop point scare release. And then I figured out that I could make it work. And so I refined the design into a Swiss Army switchblade to make sure that there was room for everything inside. And the first one I built that was a scare release worked really well. It was covert. You could show it to someone, and if they didn't know how to open it, they couldn't. And if you ever got pulled over by the police and you had to empty your pockets, it just looks like you're ready to run of the mill, you know, Swiss Army knife.
Right.
And it's not going to really draw any attention to it. So basically the liners, the blade, the spring, all the parts are all exactly the same, and I can just change the handle material. And basically, it can use just about anything as long as it's going to be stable enough that it won't crack or break, and that I can mill it to hide the mechanism underneath the scale. About a year ago, I opened my books, and I took about 30 orders. And then from there, I've been whittling down my order list. For the Switcharmy Switchblades, I'm not taking orders for them just because the demand is so high, and I kind of like playing around with the different handle configurations. But I think the variety is nice because there are some guys who like orange ones or a black one. I can change the color of the G that I put on it, and I put a G to, one, to signify for my last name, which is Gedraitis, and it looks like a shield that the Swiss Army knife also has. Each of these Swiss Army knives requires a lot of hand fitting, a lot of hand tuning to make it work properly. You can't make it too difficult to fire, and you can't make it too easy. So there's that fine line, so we spend a lot of time tuning each one so that way it's just right so you can hand it to anybody. And once they know how to open it, they can easily open it. The best part about these is when they're done and it works properly and you open it, and it has that satisfying sound of it just clicking open.